Thank you very much. My wife pointed out this morning in the hotel, we got USA Today, and on the front page, the title of the article was, "When it comes to family, there's no place like your hometown." And we kind of snickered at that, thinking of what we were talking about tonight. Over here, I'm going to need to get the curtains open for the last 20 years or so, well, I guess the last 30 years or so, I've been doing this. I've had the pleasure of managing and developing public entertainment facilities ranging from beautiful historic theaters like this to 70,000 seat football, baseball stadiums. And for the last 20 years, our company has specialized in historic preservation projects. And what I really wanted to do tonight was to share with you just a few of those projects. And one of the reasons that I wanted to do that was it's a little daunting when you first start looking at a project like this. And sometimes I think it's helpful if you find out that other communities across the country have had success and have had great benefit from the work that they've done, which is similar to what we're hoping your community will take on. And the opportunity that Tom is presenting to the community to ensure that this really fantastic building is here for generations to come. And the really, really sad thing is we've seen over the course of the 20 years that I've been doing this, and I know over the course of Tom, I'm sure over the course of your career and your life in this business, you've seen so many of these buildings disappear. And we've dedicated ourselves in our country, in our company, to making sure that fewer and fewer of these buildings disappear. And one of the ways that that happens is when the community just says, it's not acceptable anymore. We find cities all over America that started out with 6 or 7 or 10 beautiful theaters like this, and they're now down to 1 and 9 parking lots. Or maybe the one theater that's left is now a bookstore, or it's a church, or it's whatever. You know, they're just turned into all kinds of odd things, and we're just kind of losing these beautiful, beautiful buildings that you can never, never replace. If you built a building like this today, it wouldn't look like this. And so I wanted to share with you a little bit of what's happened just in 3 of the cities that I've worked in over the last 20 years. I don't have time to go through all the cities, but I wanted to share with you. I'm going to try to do this without turning my back on you. But basically the idea is to use a historic theater as a vital tool for economic development, for cultural growth, and for most importantly, for what I call building a sense of community. That a building like this is where people come and gather, and where you see your friends, and where you see your neighbors, and where your family comes together. And that can happen, as we know, through film, and all the times that you come here to see movies. And it also can happen through seeing your children dance on this stage. It can happen with you, actually. You might not admit this to the person next to you, but it can happen with you acting on the stage. And it can happen with you coming here and seeing Tony Bennett on the stage. It doesn't really matter, but it's a way for the community to come together. And that's why we put so much energy into this. And there's, I'm just going to say one really quick story about these beautiful buildings. The very first building, and I'm just killing myself for not putting it in this slideshow, the very first building that our company restored, about a year after we restored it, as so often happens, the word around town was, oh, don't go down to the Tower Theater because the acoustics are bad. You know, those old buildings have really bad acoustics, which is not true. So if anybody tells you that, it's not true. But everybody likes to say that. So about a year after we opened, we had Tony Bennett come perform at that theater. And after he finished his show, he came out to do an encore. He came up with the microphone and he said, man, they just don't make buildings like this anymore. This is the most beautiful theater. You know what I'd really like to do? I just want to sing a cappella in this. The acoustics in this place are incredible. He put the microphone down and he sang the song, I'll Be Seeing You in All the Old Familiar Places. And he sang it just with his booming voice. And we never heard again. forever. How bad, because since we're in that great old building, forever, that was the building in town everybody wanted to perform in. So I want to share with you, this particular theater is in California. This is in a little town called Eureka, which is a town of about 30,000 people. And this is what the building looked like in 1928. It was beautiful. And this is what the building looked like 24 months ago. It had gone through all these iterations, and it eventually became a department store, and it eventually became condemned. This is what the building looks like today. And incredible effort by a lot of people. Here's the inside of the building. And you can see five grand pianos on the stage. We were awaiting a performance of a group called the Five Browns, which are five brothers and sisters who all attended Juilliard, and they tour the country, they tour the world, performing together. It's the most magnificent thing you've ever seen, these five young kids in their 20s that are all playing classical music together. And you can see how beautiful this building is that once it was restored, and all the loving care that went into restoring it. This building can still show film, and it can still do, we do a huge number of community events, and we also do professional headliner entertainment in this show, in this theater. 2 weeks ago, Wynonna Judd performed. It's called the Arca Center for the Performing Arts. This young woman in the middle pulling her hair out is one of my employees, so I put her up there because that's how we feel when we're doing this for a living. And this guy over here playing the bass is just, I think he's really cool because he's from the town and he just comes down there. Once a month we have these things called Arts Alive where people come down to the neighborhood and the whole neighborhood becomes, all the arts groups come down and celebrate the arts literally once a month, 12 months a year. And this was during Arts Alive. And just to give you an idea of how it brings the neighborhood alive to stimulate local businesses. The audiences that happen, I don't know if this will work or not, but this woman here is the vice president of our company. She books all the talent. Here she is with Kenny Rogers at the grand opening of this at this particular theater. So you see what happens. This is the back of that theater. We painted, I didn't personally, I wish I could. But this is actually really a bank. Somebody asked me earlier if that woman going to the bank was part of the mural. That is a woman. And these are the cars in the parking lot. That's the bank, the back of the theater. It shows you what is possible with these wonderful projects. And across the street from that front entrance of the theater is this mural on the parking lot wall. So we've created this downtown in this little tiny town that is just like it's like the art capital of the world. And it's a little blogging town. And people are just going crazy. And we're selling out every show. People are just, the downtown's just coming alive. So it's very, very exciting. It's brought a lot of spirit to the town. This is another theater I want to share with you. This was built in the 1930s. This actually was a high school campus at one time. The entire campus has been restored. All of the original historic buildings on the campus have been restored. And now there's a university that is there, and the city bought the campus and uses it as their community center. So the gymnasium is there, and the football field, and the track, and all the art classes that happen there, and all the recreation programs that happen there. And the only thing that they had never done was fix the auditorium. And so they hired us, and we said, don't fix the auditorium. Turn the auditorium into a beautiful theater for your community. And so we restored it exactly as it was in the 1930s. Except this beautiful piece of art in the front, which were these floating glass balls that we had an artist do for us custom. But this beautiful theater is the work of community members just like you that raised money. This was an $8 million project. In this particular case, the city's redevelopment agency put in $5 million, and the volunteers raised $3.5 million. And this was a small town. This was a town of about 35,000.